following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look, oh, it's a beautiful thing. Get our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We gonna take it by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But yeah. Holy, I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Let's take a look at one of our four agreements. Create new agreements based on respect and love. Take the responsibility to make new agreements with those you love. If an agreement doesn't work, change the agreement. Create a new one. Use your imagination to explore all the possibilities. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 66, NASDAQ up 17, S&P's up 5, gold contract up $5.10, trading at $13.55 an ounce. You got silver up 7 cents, $15.06 an ounce. Light sweet crude, flat. $54.02 a barrel. Notes and bonds. 10-year note up 9 ticks. 127.25. 30-year up 10. 155.10. King dollar. King dollar down 483 ticks. Trading at 96.675. The euro is at 112.38. The yen is at 108. And the pound is at 126 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. I know what's going on in your world. Let's go to the world of bonds, folks, because guess what? Rates are going down lower and lower. If we go take a look at this 10-year right now, what you're going to see is that the 10-year took out its high yesterday, continued over today. You got an ABC structure on the way up. You get price, volume, you get all of the above. Your B point on this is 127.19. Your A is at that 124.10. Bottom line, you get about 3 points, which is going to get you into the 130 mark. Right now, you're at 127.10. If you want to see something wild, folks, okay, bottom line is that what you're going to see out here is that we're going to bust apart the 2%, and your next leg, busting up that baby apart, you can see right now you're at the lower end of this range. Yesterday, we hit a low of 201.48. It bounced back. Today, you hit 201.81, and right now you're 203.36. That being said, when I bring this back, what you're going to see, which is wide open right now, is the 1.73 mark, okay? So we're hammering into the swing point from the 2.014. That was the low that was established out here in the week of September 8th in 2017. And you can see the strength. The election week of 2016 was the strength. That's when the 10-year rate went from 1.7 to 2.1 in 1 week. Well, we are already into that bar. The bottom of that bar is 1.73, and that's where 1.71, actually. That's where I'm getting this number from, because once you break this, that's your next leg down. That's when you get a sign of strength like that, that's considered almost a swing point. Bottom line, if we break that, then it's going to be wild. Then it's at all-time lows, which is 1.31, okay? So that is pretty intense. Gold. Gold contract is on an ABC structure on the way up. What you have out here, if we go look at the gold contract, you're going to see, you talk about pushing with volume, man. This is really cool how this is shaking out. We have done 285,000 contracts today. We're going against this February 20th level, and there's no doubt going against this level, you know, when you do this many contracts, of course, you're going to have seller on the other side also. 1361.50. We bring this back, what you're going to see last Friday, bottom line, we did 358,000 contracts. We got to 1362, gave it up on price, closed at 1341. Yesterday, you did 376,000 contracts. You got up to the price point of 1358. You closed at 1350. Today, you're at 286 right now. That'll end up doing maybe like 300,000 contracts. Bottom line, doesn't look to me like it's going to give it up in price at all, though. This is going to get intriguing here. Silver. We go take a look at the silver contract. Silver also caught a bid out here today. What do you have with the silver contract now? Silver is trading 80,000 contracts. We are at 1507. Your swing there is 1515. We hit 1510 out here today. This also is pushing highs and pushing highs with volume. King dollar. What do we have with king dollar? Okay, so we've been through this before. Bottom line, we'll see whether they get some follow through. King dollar is down 458 ticks. You get 26,000 contracts traded. Now, what king dollar has done is that it's broken. In fact, it actually broke the uptrend on June 3rd. Let me put this on a continuous contract so you can see how this is set up. So we take this, I'll put this on a weekly so you can kind of get a little bit clearer edge on it. And what you're going to see is that I'll go 2 years. That way I can do it better. Yeah, sure. Okay, so when we take a look at this, what you're going to see is that your bottom here, Your decisive break was 3 weeks ago. And what we had done, we jumped right back inside the trend again. Then we just gave it up again. So bottom line, this is saying that good old King Dollar now wants to get down to the bottom of the consolidation. The bottom of that consolidation is 93,395. That totally is in harmony with where the bonds are going. It's also in harmony where gold wants to go, meaning that ABC structure on the way up. We go take a look at the S&Ps. Let's go take a look at the SPY and see where the SPY is laying out here. We have out here with the SPY. The SPY's trading up 94 cents. You're at 293.34. The high is 294.95. The high of yesterday was at 293.57. Bottom line is that we've hit 293.50 out here today. We got plenty of time, folks, coming into this close here. To really get the animal juices up inside this market, because the bottom line is that Federal Reserve, no doubt, is going to be going down on rates in the coming months. We had out here the probability. Look at this. Oh, this is pretty intense. The probability of a rate cut, that's 100%. Oh, my God. We haven't seen that before. If you're watching Tiger TV, I just brought up the Fed Fund probability chart, and now we are at 100% rate cut at the next meeting. This is pretty wild, man. Yeah. Bottom line is that, we'll see where this shakes out. Powell was having a news conference out there. Bottom line is that whatever is out there, it seems like the uncertainty. I mean, if you listen to the press conference, the uncertainty over trade, how this whole deal is coming out. Dow Industrial's up 78, Nasdaq's up 26, S&P's up 7.5. Stay right there, folks. We got our man, Mr. Steve Dahl, coming back with me. We're going to be talking TAS Market Profile, and we are doing a webinar tonight, 5 o'clock. Come join us. The way you join us, just go on our website at TFNN with the featured content. Hit subscribe at the TAS Profile. Great piece of software. You'll learn how to use it upside down. It comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Come right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
It's amazing to think that Tom O'Brien started his weekly Gold Report 17 years ago with the first issue published April 7th, 2002, when gold was trading at under $300 per ounce. Gold peaked at more than $1,900 in 2011, and after spending many years consolidating at lower prices, gold may be poised for its next big run. Tom O'Brien publishes his weekly Gold Report every Monday morning for subscribers, consisting of coverage of the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, bonds, South African Rand, as well as 25 different mining equities with specific buy-sell recommendations. As of April 1st of this year, the Gold Report currently has 8 active positions with an average unrealized profit of almost 8% for each open trade. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your Gold Report subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Don't let gold's next big run pass you by. Sign up today. Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien have just announced a special webinar on June 19th for all subscribers to the TAS Profile Scanner. Steve and Tom will break down the trade matrix, market breadth, heat grid, as well as the three-step process you can use with the TAS Profile Scanner to identify market movers and how to capitalize on that move. For all the details and to get started with the TAS Profile Scanner today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. With a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to risk. Go sign up today. TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials up 70. You get the NASDAQ up 26. S&P's up 7.5. Let's go over to my man, Mr. Steve Dahl, as we do each and every Wednesday at 20 past the first hour. Steve is the president of TAS Profile Scanner. We are going to be doing a webinar tonight, folks, 5 to 6 Eastern Standard Time. Real easy to come into this webinar. You come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see right under featured content, TAS Profile Scanner. You hit that button. As you hit it, you can just hit subscribe. It's only $97 a month. It comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. It's an outstanding piece of software, folks. I use it each and every day. Phenomenal piece of software. As you're over here, you can also just go right down to the very end. Steve's puts 12 videos together with us, awesome videos. You just hit click here. Bottom line, you can check out some of the videos until you join us at 5 p.m. tonight as we're growling and prowling, checking this great piece of software out. What's going on, brother?
Hey, what's happening? I've been looking forward to this day, well, for weeks. So I'm looking forward to doing that workshop with you and showing everybody in the viewing audience how to make good use of the TAS Profile Scanner today's workshop later.
No doubt. And, you know, we got movement out here. There's no doubt about that. I mean, you get movement in the indices, you got movement in the currencies, you got movement in the commodities. Bottom line is that a lot of movement, a lot of green on the screen out here today.
You can see that. That's for sure. And that's one of the things I'm going to be talking about. Obviously, we've got a strong market here, a relentlessly strong market. I'm going to show you how to look for both the bullish of the bull, but also if you are a deep down bear, where there still could be some bearish plays using the scanner.
No doubt. Now, what's happening, folks, is that if you happen to be watching Tiger TV, you're seeing Steve's screen right now, and this layout, when you're looking at this layout, folks, it's so cool because you have a 60-minute layout, you have a 240-minute layout, you have a daily, and you have a weekly. And when we're looking at these, what you're trying to figure out, folks, is that, okay, you get an equity that's strong, a commodity that's strong, a currency that's strong. Well, how strong is it? And how long has it been strong for? So when you happen to be looking at those little numbers that are inside those boxes, what that is telling you is that how many days are, in fact, how many weeks this has been strong. I mean, the way this is laid out, Steve, is just so cool, man.
Watch this. Those of you that are in the Tiger's Den looking at the scanner dashboard right now, this is kind of the cockpit of the entire interface. Let me show you. I'm going to go to weekly sorts, which is going to show me only those stocks that are bullish on the weekly. The big picture, you know, if you're a long-term buy and hold investor, you want to pay attention to those weeklies. And then what I'm able to do is I'm able to come to the dashboard here and sort. And so I can get these basically in order, those that have been, you know, bullish for one consecutive week. But if you scroll way down to the bottom here, look at what we have down here. Fifth Third Bank. I actually just opened up an account for the kids over here at Fifth Third. And look, for 25 weeks, this thing has been in the bull camp. And when you broaden out the chart here, you could see, let me back up a little bit here, but there we go. This one in both the daily and the weekly time frame is basically gearing up to still have some pretty good positive things happening, even though it's gone through, if you look back from basically June last year through October, had some challenges, a real pullback through that Q into Q3, Q4. You're seeing it start to equalize. It's going sideways and gathering up some real nice support and volume profile here. You can see that on the weekly.
It's pretty amazing. You know, that's where, you know, whether I don't know when this saying was done, but that's when you truly know that the trend is your friend, right?
No doubt. I mean, any of these. I mean, you could see there's a whole bunch of them here that anywhere between 15 and 25 weeks have been bullish. There's Microsoft even here for 15 weeks. It's been a good bull. And look what the market's done.
Oh, yeah. Microsoft's definitely one of the strongest stocks. It is the strongest stock in the NDX 100. There's no doubt.
Indeed.
You know, when you're looking at like a Microsoft, folks, this is kind of phenomenal for a stock that has so many shares. We went from, and just this year alone, from $93 up to $135. And just picture what that takes, though, because you have 7.6 billion shares. So it's like you don't move a stock like that unless there's dramatic buying in a huge way by huge funds. Okay, that's a lot of shares, man.
It is. That's more than you and I can muster together, I think.
I'm telling you, man. Pretty amazing. You know, so can you show them the market breadth? Because this market breadth, folks, what happens with the market breadth, it's pretty amazing. What it's telling you, the market breadth, it's telling you how many equities are above the profiles, in the profiles, or below the profiles. And it's a great way of really understanding, you know, is there momentum going higher? Is there momentum going lower? Or are you in a market that the bulls and bears are just fighting it out and it's kind of like an even deal out here?
No doubt. In fact, if you're watching the Den again, I have the market breadth up there. This is a daily time frame. In the top right up here, you can drop down and look at weekly, daily, 4-hour, or the hourly. I got daily up there right now. And over here on the left, I like to call it the poker game between the bulls and the bears. You can see who's got the most amount of chips stacked up. You can see it's clear as day here where it says above in green. That's the bulls. 306 stocks in the S&P 500 are over 60% market cap weighted. Are in favor of the bulls. And look at how you could see as this green line starts to head higher. That's the mounting, you know, candidates joining the bulls. Their army is growing, the bullish army. And you can see what the market's doing with the simple line chart. The market follows suit. But the real edge built in breadth is that you get this information before it shows up at the index level price individual stocks. And that's the real power of any market breadth type tool is it's giving you, might be 1 or 2 days before it shows up in the market, you've got time to get your trade on using the TAS profile scanner. And away you go. You've got that 2-day jump start on the rest of the world.
And it's so cool, folks, of this chart. I mean, I use this chart a lot. I use the market breadth a lot because even intraday, if you're trading futures, it's very helpful understanding in the S&P where it wants to go. Now, what's so cool here is that we didn't get a spike higher. It was a steady move, because when you get the fast spikes, whether they're higher or lower, well, you got to watch those because then they'll back off, you know, just give them like, what, 2, 3, 4 minutes, they back off, which is so cool also. So there's a lot of different ways that you can use this tool to basically understand how the market's going as to how you trade. But when you get a steady one like that, what I've found, Steve, is that, okay, that is steady, man. That's just like coming at you, you know?
It is. I mean, it really allows you to see when the Bulls or the Bears, for that matter. It's been a lot of the Bulls, obviously, leapfrogging the Bears lately, but it goes the other way too. And this really can be a lifesaver, especially if and when. My goodness, I feel like I've been saying this for months. If and when we get that,
I've been saying it for years.
I'm ready when you are, man. I'm ready to hit the eject button, but I want to be ready at the right time. And that's not today.
No, there's no doubt. There's no doubt. And folks, the webinar is going to be awesome. It's a full hour. Steve's going to be walking us through his three-step move, how he looks at the TAS profile scanner every day, how it can help you, and it's so fast, folks. I mean, it gets rid of all the huge work that, I mean, if you go to a 50, 100 stocks, you know, bottom line, you can hit a couple of buttons, then you can get the candidates, then go through those equities, whatever way that you like to basically go through equities. So check it out. Front page of TFNN. Go into featured content. Hit subscribe. Steve and I, we really look forward to seeing you at 5 o'clock. Steve, you have a great one, safe one. We're going to be talking another hour and a half, man.
Sounds good, partner.
Cook it, man. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at tfnn.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of tfnn.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Nadex Options Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here inside this market. We'll see whether we get any volume. It hasn't been that volatility for a Fed day. I thought that we'd actually get a lot more. You get Advanced Micro right now. That's up 13 cents. We have, let's see, Facebook's down 178. That's been on a rocket ship. You get Apple flat. We have PG&E. That's up $1.47. It must be working out there. Bankruptcy somewhere. BYNB. Let's go take a look at Beyond Meat. This baby here. Okay, so it was at 174 today, 166. That was the pop yesterday. That pop yesterday got that all the way up to 201. Monster number, no doubt. Inside the NDX 100 now, the strength versus the weakness out here today. There we go. So you get Adobe up 5% or 1458. Adobe came out with their numbers last night. Now, it looks like Adobe's having a hard time getting over its high because, believe me, I brought this up earlier. That should do it, though. 291.70. Yeah, it's pushing with volume. We hit 291.42. Now, this is going to be a cool one to watch, folks, okay? Meaning that if you enter price and volume, what you're going to see here is that you're pushing into this higher swing point, the swing point, which by itself was a pretty good swing point, meaning with volume, from the 29th of April. You haven't broken it yet, but you can see the expansion. Last swing point had 1.2 million, you're pushing with 1.9. So the way that I look at this, that means it's gonna blow through that number in a big way too. So we take a look at the Mercado Libre is up 3.2%. You get Cadence Design up 3%, and you get T-Mobile up 2.6. Taken away from it, NetEase is down 2.8. You got O'Reilly Automotive down 1.9. You got Cognizant Technology off 1.5. Let's go take a look at O'Reilly Automotive and see what they're having to say. So this baby here has some volume on the way down. Like, did they come up with numbers? Let's see what they had did. Well, they're just selling it down. That's the bottom line. They're selling it down. Let's go take a look at the Dow Industrials, the strength versus the weakness inside the Dow Industrials. Point-wise out here, we have the Dow right now up 72 points. United Health is putting 33 positive points into the Dow. You have Visa putting 11. Travelers is putting 10. Disney's putting 10. Taken away from it, Boeing is putting a negative 28. You get Dow, DuPont putting a negative 7, 3M 5.5. No real big deal there. We go back into this. Let's go to the TLT and take a look at the TLT because you get notes, bonds on the move once again. Here you go. You're pressing this this high and you get an expansion of volume. Now the TLT will need more volume. The volume high on the TLT right now is 17.8 million. Yesterday it did 10, and today we'll do probably about 11. You know, the number to keep your eye on is at 132.58, 132.64 right now. We'll see where this basically closes at the day, and then what type of follow through. Most times, folks, when you get a Fed meeting that's like this, right, that the market itself is going to digest this, and the way that the S&P as well as the NDX 100 yesterday took out their swing points with volume is saying that we're going to be over the highs. That's how this shakes out. You know, we'll see whether you get a blow-off high, but the bottom line is that the SPY yesterday took out its high going back from the, took out its B point from the 11th of June. That's saying, guess what? It's going to go over the 294. NDX 100, same type of setup. So there's some real action out here. Small caps still are the laggards in a huge way. If we take a look at the small caps out here, what you're going to see, IWM 154. Your high in April was 161.11. And your all-time high, though, you have to go all the way back to August of last year, which is 173.39. So it's really intriguing, actually, that the small caps bottom line are so far off of their high. We get Powell come out. Well, let's see exactly what a couple of quotes he had out here. The Federal Reserve indicated a readiness to lower interest rates for the first time in more than a decade, citing uncertainties in the outlook that have increased the case for a cut as officials seek to prolong the near-record U.S. economic expansion. Here's the quote here. My colleagues and I have one overreaching goal, to sustain economic expansion. Powell told the press conference following the decision, noting that many policymakers see a strengthening case for a cut. They also had asked Powell about the aspect of Trump demoting him, and Powell responded to a reporter's question, said he thinks the law is clear that I have a four-year term and I fully intend to serve it. He declined to comment directly on the president's public criticism of the central bank, but said that the Fed is deeply committed to carrying out our mission and that its independence from politics is an important institutional feature that has served the economy as well as the country. The Fed expects a strong labor market, inflation to be near its goal, but uncertainties about the outlook have increased, the Federal Reserve Open Market Committee said in a statement following a two-day meeting. In light of these uncertainties, this is a quote from the Federal Reserve statement now, in light of these uncertainties and muted inflation pressures, the committee will closely monitor the implications of incoming information for economic outlook and will act as appropriate to sustain the expansion. And if you do look at the, I got to bring this up just one more time. If you actually look at the Fed fund futures, what you're going to see out here is that it is a 100% move that on the July 31st meeting that you're going to get a rate cut. And I don't remember ever seeing a 100% deal. Let me go over the SPY again, because one of our targets have a question about what I just said. Okay, so what happened, folks, is this. The SPY, as well as the QQQ, took out a B point yesterday of an ABC structure on the way up. Your B point on this is $291.40. That was the high that was generated out here on the 11th of June. Your A point is 273. So 273 is your A, 291 is your B. So we're dealing with, 16 points. Well, then you're going to add that onto the C, which is 287, which is going to get you up there at basically a 303. And you can see that you're at 294, the high. So when you do these price projections on how we took out the B point yesterday, that gets you over the highs, period, inside the SPY as well as the QQQ. The IWM doesn't have one. The real question is going to be, you know, are they going to be able to make it? That's what it really comes down to. Notes and bonds are saying that, guess what? It is absolutely unbelievable, actually, that the rates are going to be going lower. Let's go take a look at Toll Brothers. Look at that. This is intriguing that Toll Brothers is not getting juice when, for real estate business folks, that is a good scene. Coming right back.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 75, Nasdaq's up 33, S&P's are up 8.5. Let's see what we have volume-wise as we're coming into the close out here. So right now inside the NYSE, you're dealing with 459, and that's not a lot of volume, but I expect they're going to throw some volume in at the close here. Now, the Nasdaq's at 1.6, and 1.6 probably will get to 2.1, 2.2. Not over the highs of yesterday yet, inside that NDX 100. Let's go take a look at the ESU, at the futures right now. Yeah, futures are just overtaken, I believe. Let's see. 29.3650. Oh, my God, look at that. Okay, so they're right at it. They're at 29.34 right now. They hit 29.36 today. And it's the extra 50 that we have to get up and over that number. Let me just see this for a second. Intraday. Okay, so you got intraday out here. The spike was incredible, no doubt, when the Fed came out. So check this out, folks. When the Fed came out, oh, my God, this is pretty wild, that you had a spike. You had a 20-point spike. The low was 29.15. The high was 29.35. That's pretty intense. There's no doubt about that. We're at 3 minutes into it. Yeah, this is going to take it out. This is going to take that high out of the 29.35, I see. Okay. Still, the way this is shaking out right now, it looks to me like it's going to take it out. I expect what we're going to see here is you're going to see a little run coming into the close out here. That's the way this shakes out. This just has the feeling, not only just for that run into the close, but the way that this hasn't got, like, euphoria going in a big way, that when it comes out across all the platforms, of course, the news is already out, that, yes, rates are going down, you're going to get a pop higher in the morning. Because inside of this, the thing that's intriguing, you know, we've been in a low-rate atmosphere for a huge amount of time. What I didn't realize is that the last time that rates actually went down were 10 years ago. That's pretty intense. Because what does happen is this, folks. When rates go up or go down, most times it is not just like once or twice. You know, what had happened the last time that rates actually, that the market got smoked very quickly. I think it was about 3 or 4 years ago. They had hit the rate up, and then the market went crazy. And then they, bottom line, just said, okay, hold it. We're not going to do anything for a year. So when they go down, however, what does happen is that the bottom line is that they go down, and they go down for quite some time. You know, the real kicker here, which I think all of us are questioning, is that, okay, is this all about a recession? Is this all about trade? Or does the Fed, bottom line, see deflation genie out here in a huge way? It seems to me that every time I keep looking at this, it's the deflation genie. And the reason I'm saying that is that the number yesterday that the number in the bond market that are paying negative rates, meaning that you are paying, that is registered. This is a registered number, folks, that you can prove in the bond market, is $13 trillion. So think about that for a second. It's hard to comprehend. Now that's deflation, man. You know, that's what it comes down to. The real kicker is if you can figure out, you know, what, right off the bat, it says cash is not worth anything. So the real question is that why, what is the asset that they're going to go into? And then, you know, one of the Tigers have a great question here. Then why is gold going up? Well, gold's going up because people are buying it. You know, that would make sense to me because, yeah, watch this. This would be the correlation. The correlation inside the gold market for years would be that you don't buy gold because you don't get percentages interest rate in the gold market, right? Now, that doesn't hold anymore because you don't get interest even if you put money in the bank. The other side of that, not the other side of it, it would say to me that gold should go exponential as real estate should, as any hard asset should. Because why? Because guess what? If there's $13 trillion, that means that there's more cash and fiat currencies in the market than they know what to do with. So eventually they're going to say, okay, well, if that's the case, am I going to pay someone to hold my cash, or I'm going to go get something of value? And, you know, we'll see how it shakes out. But every time I look at that number, I'm saying to myself, okay, would I rather pay someone something or have a hard asset? Personally, I want a hard asset all day long. You know, I've been doing the gold market long enough that what happens in the gold market is that this is large banks just trying to keep a lid on it as much as you can, because what happens with the gold, if gold gets too wild, the market, as well as traders, investors, will really say, okay, now what's going on? And then you can lose confidence in the dollar. And the last thing that the Treasury wants is losing confidence in the dollar. And if you listen to the press conference with Powell, he had got asked a question about the currency, the dollar, currency manipulation, and all the above. And bottom line, he came out and said, hey, listen, that's the Treasury. That's a question for the Treasury. They have nothing to basically, policy-wise, to do with the U.S. dollar in general. And guess what? The Treasury does, though. The Treasury does in spades. And the Treasury's job, I suspect, is to make sure that U.S. dollar stay stable. Doesn't have to stay strong. It has to stay stable, though, because the fact of the matter is that the amount of deficits that we have, it better stay stable, you know, because we are going to be the interest rate. There's no doubt that the interest rate structure, when it goes down, it's just not all of us paying less money. It's the Fed is the biggest borrower. Well, and I'm talking about the federal government, not the Federal Reserve. The federal government is the biggest borrower in the marketplace. And of course, as rates come back down, guess what? That makes a huge difference. GDX, let's go take a look at the GDX. GDX out here, bottom line, I believe it took it out. Let's see, 2370, yeah. So we took out the swing point from February 20th. We put this on a weekly. This is gonna be a good number, man, because this is saying that the next stop up here inside the GDX is like 25.58. This is also a takeout. Let's see. Yeah, this is a takeout with conviction, man. I like it. Yep, there's no doubt. Let me pull this back further and see if we got. Okay, so we're going to be approaching. This is going to be pretty cool. So 25.71 is the number. We take out 25.71, and guess what? Then you are talking big numbers. Then you're up to 31.79, which was the high of 2016. And it looks to me like that's where we're going. We've already had a couple of these equities get there. And the way that we had pulled back, we pulled back very slightly on that last pullback. Now we're going topside again, and you do have the juice behind it. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one mark timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 93. You get the Nasdaq up 43. S&Ps are up 10.5%. Percentage-wise out here, what you have, folks, is that you have the Dow Industrials up 0.3. You have the Nasdaq up 0.5. S&Ps are up 0.2. Gold up by 540. We're going to get to, let's go see what we have volume-wise in here right now. Yeah, 299. You're going to have 300,000. So that's got action. This is the third time that we've pressed this 1361. We hit 1360 out here today. What I expect you're going to see here, this thing is going to basically blow it away. 1401 is your price projection of that ABC structure on the way up that Gold actually had done last Friday, turned into a complex one, ran up once again. What we do have out here now is that silver once again has caught the bid. And it's all about notes and bonds. Bottom line, notes and bonds, higher price, lower yield. XAU, HUI also got some action going here. The XAU is trading at 78.23. That high of the 20th of February is 80.76. It's gunning for that number. Gold Bugs Index out here. That right now, oh, we might have hit it. Let's see. 180. I love it, man. We did it. Okay, so check it out. Gold Bugs Index, first one up here. Now, this is really positive for the gold market too, folks, because the Gold Bugs Index had been lagging the XAU. That accelerated it. Now, what you have, 180.22, we hit 180.29. We took it out. We're at 180.11. That is a big number, folks, because now what we have, as we're looking at this, let me bring this back a bit because this is going to get wild, watching how this is going to shake out. So your next number really going after this, now you're talking about a 209. And what we're also talking about, let me put this up here. I believe that you're going to see a decisive break. Yeah, you are. Cool. Yeah, 220. We got 220 on the agenda here. This was a decisive break of the downtrend that actually was out there since September of 2017. So if you haven't checked out the Gold Report, folks, great time to do it. Come over to our website at TFNN. Go to the newsletters, Gold Report. Get it for a month, 6 months, a year. It comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Dow Industrials up 59, NASDAQ up 37, S&P's up 6.5. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This is TFNN, the Tiger Financial News Network. TFNN. Headline news update.
Welcome, folks. We had the Dow Industrials finish up 39, NASDAQ up 33, S&P's up 5.5. You had Chairman Powell come out, as well as the Federal Reserve, with their statement. Bottom line is that they expect they're going to be going down on rates. And that, you know, if we look at the Fed Fund futures, there's 100% probability of that now at the next meeting, which is on July 31st. And if we kick that in, so that will get that from we're at 2.25 to 2.50 right now. The effective rate is 2.37 today. That would bring it down to 2 to 2.25, and then check it out, though. For the next rate cut, meaning bringing it down to 1.75 to 2, well, that is the meeting right after it, folks. So that's at 65% right now. So that also went higher by 20 percentage points. It was 43 this morning. It's 65.8 now. That's at the September meeting. And if we go to the third rate hike, let's see. That's pretty crazy. The third rate hike, you have it at 41% right now on December 11th. So you're talking about some heavy rate cuts in a huge way. The 10-year note, the 30-year bond, both went higher with volume. You had the 10-year note up 10 ticks, 127.26. 30-year bond up 9 ticks, 155. 10, it looks like the 10-year right now is going to break the 2% barrier. 1.73 is on the agenda. Gold contract caught a bid, has volume, as does silver. Gold is up 860, silver is up 12 cents, and King Dollar. King Dollar came down 418 ticks. That's trading 96.735, and we'll see whether we get follow through inside the King Dollar. But King Dollar did come down on volume. We did 29,000 contracts. That is saying now King Dollar will go after the lower end of this consolidation that we've been in for some time. And the lower end of that consolidation is the 94 mark. If I bring this up and put this on a continuous contract, what you're going to see when we're laying out here, I'll put it on a weekly. You're going to see that we've been kind of laying at the same place going all the way back to, it's pretty intense, the whole year, actually. This actually started October of 2018. Right now, though, it looks like 94 is on the agenda for King Doll. Stay right there, folks. Going to be coming back with some numbers after the close. Recap out here. We had the Dow Industrials trade up 38, NASDAQ up 33, S&P's up 5. We'll come right back.
TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Nadex Options Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. Great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. To begin a great relationship, know what you want. Know what the needs of your body are, what the needs of your mind are, and what fits well with you. There are millions of men and women, and some of them will make a good match for you, and others won't. The two of you only need to be a key in a lock, a match that works. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials finish up 38, NASDAQ up 33, S&P's up 6.5. Volume out here inside the NYSE, folks, they'll throw a little bit more in, but right now we're at 848 million, so not a huge amount of volume. Inside the NASDAQ composite, we're at $1.9 billion. Not a lot of volume there either. Gold contract at $9.80. This baby has the juice, folks. It has the volume. It has the price. It's an ABC structure on the way up, GCQ9. What we have out here, you're pressing the highs, and you're pressing them with volume. You've done 305,000 contracts today. And this is going to be so cool watching this shake out, because this has been a press in a huge way. Specifically, what I mean is that last Friday, you went higher. You pressed the high from the 20th of February. And the high of the 20th of February, folks, is 1361.50. What we did on last Friday went to 1362. You had 358,000 contracts. Then, bang, gives it up in price. You close out at 1341. That being said, when you go higher, folks, and that took out the B point. The B point was a price point of 1352, and it took it out with volume. So it was a complex ABC structure on the way up. Bottom line, has a price projection of 1401.70. That being said, what do we do? Yesterday, you go higher, hit the 1358 level. We do 376,000 contracts. Today, what do? Bottom line, you do 306,000 contracts, not done yet. You're laying right at that high. That's saying that that thing wants to get taken out. Silver also caught the bid out here today. We had the Federal Reserve, of course, saying that they're going to go down in rates. Now we have a 100% probability that you are going to get, this is in the Fed Fund futures rate, that you're going to get a rate cut on July 31st. And then we have a 47% chance that we're going to, no, a 67% chance, 67, that we're going to get an additional rate cut at the September 18th meeting. So you're talking about one half a point in the Fed Fund futures. Big number. We go back to the silver contract again for a second. You're going to see you did 83,000 contracts. You finished at the high of the day. I suspect what we're going to have out here tomorrow morning is that you're going to see these swing points get blown away, and I suspect we're going to get volume behind that move. Now, let's go to the note and bond market, because the note and bond market is screaming higher price, lower rates. We had the 10-year do 1.8 million contracts. It's big contract volume. It had already taken the B out, taken it out with volume. The 10-year is saying it's going to go to about the 129, 130 level. That is going to basically turn around and bring the 10-year yield under 2%. If we take a look at this, we pull up the yields chart, what you're going to see in this yield chart. Right now, this baby got down to a price point today of 2.0181. You know, now you're in a whole nother range, meaning a lower range. You bring this up, and what you're going to see is that it looks to me that we're screaming now about the 1.71. And 1.71, folks, goes back to the election of 2016. That's when yields exploded topside. In 1 week, we went from 1.7 to 2.15. And then, of course, it just, that was the beginning of yields going higher. The top of this yields going higher came in the week of October of last year. That number there was 3.2594. Check that out. We're down 1.25% from the highs that were generated in October. And guess what? Now we're down off of that, folks, without the Fed going down. The reason we're down off of that is that there's so many market participants that are buying the 10-year note, the 20-year bond, as well as the 30-year bond. So it's a big number that it's the market that drove these rates lower. Now what you're going to have is that the Fed is going to drive them lower. So you can imagine the amount of buying that's going to come in here. Because the way this works, of course, is that, yeah, you get lower rates, but what you're going to see, when I say 155.07 in a 30-year bond, that means that you're paying $1,550 for a $1,000 bond that expires in 30 years. That's how that shakes out. You know, so, well, and in this particular case, that wouldn't be expiring in 30 years, because actually when they come out, it's a different number. These are bonds that are already trading. That's how this works, okay? Bottom line, you can see the aspect, though. The aspect is that lower rates are coming at us in a large way. King dollar. King dollar also looks like that we're at 96.710. It came off the highs with volume as off that high. That is saying, bottom line, 94 is coming at us. Each and every time, you know, this consolidation has been in place since last October. And the low of that is approximately the 94 level. The high is up here at about the 97, 97 and a half level. Each time it comes up there, can't seem to make it, pulls back. This particular time, we did get a nice sign of strength last Thursday. But bottom line, it couldn't follow through on the deal. Some of the higher volume, well, actually, let's go take a look at, first we'll take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here today. And it's not that we actually got high volume. You had Bank of America down 30 cents. U.S. Steel was up 59 cents. The steel stocks are moving, too, by the way. If you go look at, let me go see if U.S. Steel did an ABC up, too. Yeah, it did. So U.S. Steel, I mean, these things have got smoked. They should have some strength, but there's small ABC structures on the way up. AK Steel was the same thing. We got a call on AK Steel yesterday. That was an ABC structure, excuse me, folks, on the way up. Pfizer's up 43 cents. You get, Freeport-McMoRan was up 6 cents. Wells Fargo down 45 cents. Sprint Corporation was up for 22 cents. Stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow Industrials finished up 38. NASDAQ up 33. S&P's up 7.5. Come right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
It's amazing to think that Tom O'Brien started his weekly gold report 17 years ago with the first issue published April 7th, 2002, when gold was trading at under $300 per ounce. Gold peaked at more than $1,900 in 2011, and after spending many years consolidating at lower prices, gold may be poised for its next big run. Tom O'Brien publishes his weekly gold report every Monday morning for subscribers, consisting of coverage of the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, bonds, South African Rand, as well as 25 different mining equities with specific buy-sell recommendations. As of April 1st of this year, the Gold Report currently has 8 active positions with an average unrealized profit of almost 8% for each open trade. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your Gold Report subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Don't let gold's next big run pass you by. Sign up today. Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien have just announced a special webinar on June 19th for all subscribers to the TAS Profile Scanner. Steve and Tom will break down the trade matrix, market breadth, heat grid, as well as the three-step process you can use with the TAS Profile Scanner to identify market movers and how to capitalize on that move. For all the details and to get started with the TAS Profile Scanner today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. With a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to risk. Go sign up today.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials up 38, NASDAQ up 33, S&P's up 7.5. And yeah, we get some buying inside the gold market, folks. It's up 1480 right now, 1365. That ABC is a little sweet little ABC. Let's go to our man John in Philly. What's going on, brother?
Hey, good afternoon, Tommy. Thanks for doing the show.
No, thanks for listening, man. Appreciate it.
Say, Tommy, I wanted to ask if you would help me think ahead a little bit on the S&P 500. And now that we know the Federal Reserve is in all likelihood going to cut rates at that late July meeting, we can factor that into our thinking. And I've been thinking about a scenario that I did not conceive of, but I heard or read somewhere in the past months. And the scenario goes like this, Tom. 2018 was a year in the S&P marked by a good correction, specifically with that 20% sell-off the last quarter. Interestingly enough, 1994 in the S&P 500 was a corrective year. And both 18 and 94, both were accompanied by the Federal Reserve raising interest rates. And in 18, it was, they raised it from, you know, 1.25 to 2.5 in a bunch of stages. And back in 94, they raised it from 3 up to 6 in a number
of stages. Yeah, in 94, the bond market got killed, folks. Yeah, right. Okay.
Right.
I remember that, yep.
And so 94 and 18, both years, the S&P went sideways. In 2019, of course, we know that the S&P has recovered all recovered all that decline, and it's back at highs. Interestingly, in 1995, the market started taking off, and in both years, 95 and 19, the Federal Reserve held the Fed funds rate steady. 2.5 this year so far, 6% back first half of 95. Then the Fed in 95 at the July meeting cut the rate from 6 to 5.75. And then they cut it again in 96, quarter, a half a point. But they cut the rates back then in 95 and 96, not because there was a recession, which there was none. Frankly, I forget why they cut it, but it wasn't a recession.
Yeah, I think there were wipeouts in the bond market beyond belief then. That's what happened.
For you, Tommy, is now that I've done is repeat some history, can you envision the scenario where the Fed does cut rates, you know, in July and maybe again a little later in the year, we get no recession, and the S&P just marches and marches higher and higher throughout the rest of 19, like it did in 1995?
Yeah. I mean, you know, when the hard thing to comprehend right now is that rates haven't been cut for 10 years. We're still only at 2.25 versus 6, what we're talking in 94. And yeah, I can. You know, I mean, I remember that time so well, because what had happened, folks, is that the rates went up dramatically and Greenspan totally blew it. And the amount of losses on Wall Street were incredible in the bond market, which people in the bond market aren't used to losing money, really. Then what ended up happening is that as soon as they got it straightened out, the market went straight up from 94 to 96. And then the market only had like a 15% pullback, but so many people lost a huge amount of money in the equity market because they were so leveraged. So the deal is that when things do get, like I suspect we're maybe coming onto this deal right now, I mean, that you have markets at highs, the Fed is still saying that, guess what, we're going to drop rates maybe 0.75% in a year. Well, if we get that, it's going to be like, where are people going to put their money? You know? So it's going to be pretty interesting watching this whole thing shake out, man. You know, right now, you know, this S&P, you know, looks to me like you got an ABC structure on the way up of, let's see, what do we got? 3,056. You know, I think the differential here would come down that if we have a trade war and we continue a trade war with China, different ballgame. Because the amount of taxes that these companies are going to be paying will not basically sustain a bottom line for them. You know what I'm saying?
And I do,
in 94, what you had, folks, is that China had really opened up 81, 82. By 94, things were really, you know, they were, if you were at the beginning of this with China, first, goods made in China, folks, were very low end. They were suspecting in the late 80s and the beginning of the 90s that China could not go up the food chain. And guess what? They went up the food chain very quickly. Bottom line, we had that going, and that's what basically had these companies making money hand over fist, because there's still plenty of people that really don't understand that. Guess what? The Walmarts of the world are up there. They're buying something for a buck over there. They're selling it for 10 bucks over here. You know what I'm saying? So,
Tommy, thanks so much for responding to that question of mine. I do appreciate it, and it will be fascinating to watch in the next couple of months. And what I will share with you, if the S&P does go to higher highs in late June and July, I'm just going to be keeping the back of my mind that 1995 analog. So thanks again.
Thanks, brother. Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Yes, there's no doubt, folks, it's pretty intense. As I said, the differential, though, inside the market in general, you know, you got to remember something. If you're going to higher prices, companies got to make more money. When you take the supply chains, all these supply chains, not 100%, but guess what? The majority of them are in China. You start adding on 25% to the wholesale price, you're going to see less money being made. Then what also ends up happening is that the money on the tax, of course, gets paid to the U.S. government. And guess what? It's the companies and you and I that are paying it, folks. It's not the country that you're coming in from. It's the importer that has to pay for it. And it is what it is. So we'll see where that shakes out. Percentage-wise, this is going to be pretty wild, watching this thing shake out. Let me go over to this gold market. I want to see this buy-in in here. This gets kind of interesting because I remember what the contract value was. Okay, it's not that much. Well, they put another 10,000 contracts in it. That's what they did. They wanted to take that out. That's the bottom line. Oh, look at that, right on the close. I got that. Okay, well, the trade's all night, but let me see this. Yeah, 8,400 contracts at that last. We just hit the 1366. That was a buy of 8,400 contracts. Now, when you take a look at this, what you're going to see is that now you're going to see that we are over the 1361.50. And that's what volume does. Push, push, push. Guess what? Whoever's sitting up there, folks, selling, selling, selling. Well, guess what? They gave it up. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial, so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See.
At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Nadex Options Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over to Oracle. Oracle just came out with numbers. Let's see what they're having to say. Oracle closed today at a price point of $52.68. It's trading up $1.80 right now, $54.45. Revenue, the estimate had been $10.94 billion. They took in $11.14 billion. Earnings per share estimate was $1.07. They took in $1.16. Their operating margin is running at 47%. It's a decent number. There's no doubt about that. Service revenue is $823 million. That's down 6.7%. Hardware revenue is $994. That's down 11%. cloud service and license support revenue, there's the number. Look at that number. Wow. $6.80 billion. That is one monster number. Now, if we take a look at this, so you're up $2, 54 approximately. Your last high out here is at 55.53. So we'll see how that baby shakes out. American Outdoor Brands, AMER, let's see. This here, I believe this is the old Springfield. This is a gun manufacturer. I think it was Springfield Rifle at one point. So Springfield, Mass. There it is. Okay, so American Outdoor Brands, fries firearms, pistols, revolvers, black powder, firearms, handcuffs. Low is $8.19. The high is $15.95. This closed at $19.14. This is trading $19.89. Now, this equity has got smoked. Let's just see what... Yeah, this has been a one-way trip on the way down. Yeah, we were at $31 in 2016, came all the way back to, well, you can do this a couple different ways, all the way back to 2006, but let's see what they're saying now. They must be pulling in some bread now, so let's see what they have. So they were looking for, they had an estimate, a sales estimate of 1.69 million. They did 1.75 million. They had an estimate of 17 cents to the bottom line. They did 26 cents. So that is no doubt, that is a big number to the bottom line. Yeah, that's. I think they rolled up all these gun companies. That would have been Springfield, Smith & Wesson. I think they're all rolled inside this. Net sales, they see first quarter net sales coming 120 million to 130 million. They see the earnings per share, 3 cents to 7 cents. Now, in the second quarter, 2020, they're... This is fiscal year 2020, which they're already in. They're still in the middle of the range. That's how that's kind of shaken up. They're definitely still in the middle of the range. Let's go to a Steelcase. See what Steelcase has to say out here. Let's see. Steelcase. This is the furniture maker. So Steelcase Class A shares. Okay, so let's see what this is. Steelcase closed at $17.77. The low for the year is 13, the high is 19. This is trading 16.30, so you got it down $1.30. Wow. Man, the last time they must have come out with numbers was a disaster. Went from, it's relevant, 18 to 16. Comes all the way up to the top again. It's going to give it up again. So let's see what Steelcase has to say. Not quite sure that, there's not as many offices big offices, you know, because you have so many people that work remotely now, folks, and it's like when you get a big office, yeah, it's one thing. You get a monster corporation, they buy the steelcase chairs, they're a fortune. Another thing when people are working at home, I don't think they're buying as many steelcase chairs. Because when you, if you notice, whenever you go into big offices also, it seems like there's more chairs than there are people. So let's see what they had to say out here. So okay, here we go. Okay. First quarter revenue, $823 million. The estimate had been $837 million. So that was down. Second quarter revenue, they had an estimate of $938 million. They see that going up. I see that going up. Their gross margin is 31%. Earnings per share, 15 cents. That being said, bottom line, it doesn't look like they got any traction out here, you know. In fact, you're going south versus going north. No two ways about that. You get, yeah. Let's go take a look at the chip space, okay? So first I'm gonna go to the SMHs, because what we had out here is that the chips yesterday was the number that basically took off and took off topside in a huge way. That being said, SMHs, you know, they had a great day yesterday. Yesterday went from a price point of 102 to 106. Today, not much. Bottom line is that, you know, you were up 25 cents, no big deal there. That's gonna need more juice. Let's go over to AMD. So AMD is going to be a great one to watch, folks. The reason is this. What AMD has done is that it already has tested the swing high that was established out here going back in September of 2018. And it failed. You know, if we take a look at this on a weekly, you're going to see on a weekly, you came into it with 370 million versus a billion shares. Couldn't handle it. So we'll see whether this thing wants to back down at all, meaning into the, because if we do get a back down, you're going to get a back down that's pretty dramatic, because the lower end of that consolidation is $16.50. Let's go to a couple of the casino stocks. What we had yesterday, casino stocks did get a slight bid. Wynn Resorts up 32 cents, and that had taken a B point out, taken it out with volume. LVS, we go take a look at Las Vegas Sands. Same setup. That Las Vegas Sands are going to need more volume, because we got volume yesterday, but not as much as they got at the B point. You know, so there's no doubt you get some moving parts there. The strongest, one of the strongest stocks still in the marketplace, folks, is Microsoft. Microsoft, I believe, hit another all-time high today. Yeah, it did. $135.93. And this is, it's pretty amazing, particularly because of the amount of shares that are outstanding and the movement that this stock has. And the movement, no doubt, has been extraordinary. I mean, when you go back to, my God, you go back to 2009, it's hard to even comprehend. You're talking about $14.83. And it's been a one-way trade. You know, outside of 2014, you know, you had some big choppiness. Anytime, let's see, if you were a buyer at October of 2015, I don't think, well, you look back, is that, yeah, just in December. In December, we went from, October to December, you were from 116 to 93, and then it just took off topside once again. Big number. Don't forget, folks, Steve Dahl and myself, we're going to be doing a webinar 5 o'clock tonight. You can be in this webinar by coming over to our website at TFNN. Go right to the TAS profile scanner. Steve's going to walk you through that whole scanner. Just hit subscribe. It comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Come right back, folks.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Directions Daily S&P Biotech 3x Bull and Bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today.
An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over and take a look at that yen. So what we're going to have out here tonight, folks, is that the correlation in between the yen and gold is pretty direct. And the yen today, right now, we're at 108.13. Now, the bottom of this consolidation is 107.82. What happens is this. If the yen goes down in price, it gets stronger. So right now, the yen is 108 yen to one U.S. dollar. You get down to 100 yen to one U.S. dollar, bottom, you can see how it gets stronger. The way this is set up right now, you know, we have a old spike low out here at 104. Now, that was a real trade. It was more than just one trade. It was January 3rd. I remember this because it was like there was some carnage for folks that actually were trading the yen, because that's unheard of that you go from 108 to 104.87. But bottom line, that's exactly what happened. The way we've been in a consolidation right now, this consolidation that started May 21st. It looks to me, though, that baby is going to be game. We go over to the euro. We take a look at the euro. You see, as the dollar index had pulled back today, bottom line, the euro, I'll show you this intraday. So euro, as soon as the Fed came out, you know, you can see it flat out. Yeah, exactly at 2 o'clock, the yen spiked from 112.19 to 112.54. We'll see whether the euro can break its downtrend. You know, let me look at this. It actually did already break it. Now, this would be the test of coming back. And now you go topside again. So let me see this. Yeah, you definitely broke the downtrend from, let me see if I broke the longer one. No, we didn't break the longer one. Okay, so you broke the, we had broken, when we went topside in the yen, I mean in the pound on June 3rd, we broke the downtrend. That's saying that this is the pound, I'm sorry, folks. We broke on June 3rd, pound goes topside. We go from 112 111.55 to 112.62. That's the end of the pound once it run to 114. That's how that shakes out. Now let's go look at the British pound. Okay, so the pound, 126.43. Oh, this needs a lot more help. This got help today, but this is pretty wild. This also got the spike. It was going up all day, but then it did get the spike as two. Now, this is going to need more help. There's no doubt about it. So we'll see where that baby does shake out. The Canadian dollar, let's just go look at the dollar, the Canadian dollar for a second and see how that's shaking out. That got stronger. So 132 Canadian dollar to one U.S. dollar. That looks like it wants to get down into this 130. Now, that would make sense because guess what? If we do have that dollar index start pushing back, we had volume in it today. Well, if we get the pushback, they're still buying gold out here. So this is going to get really interesting. You got to remember something, that gold right now, folks, so here, and also an ABC structure on the way up or on the way down, folks, they love straight line moves. And, you know, what is a straight line move? Well, if we take a look at this contract right here, in fact, I'll set this up for you so you can see how this the first move was done. So if we take a look at it, you're going to see your first move out here went from the low that was established on May 21st at 1274. The high was established at 1352 on the 7th. Well, you can see, you know, from the 30th to the 7th, that's about as straight as you can get. Each day, huge acceleration. Now what we did, we messed around here for 3 or 4 days. You took it out. It turned into a complex ABC structure up because of the fact that we got above it with volume. You closed below it. When you do that, what happens is that it's a complex ABC structure on the way up. And what would confirm that is that when you back down, which we did back down on Monday, you back down with 239,000 contracts versus up with 358. That's what, so it had the makings of that complex one. Then what do? We basically take off topside again yesterday with 376. You take off topside again today, you get 321. And now you get what's happening in this market right now, I'd say you get a little bit runaway that's happening. Because the market participants themselves are going to actually start looking at the GDX, the HUI, the XAU. And if you go take a look at the Gold Bugs Index, what you're going to see is that the Gold Bugs Index closed over its February high. I'll close right at it. Yeah, 180.22 is the number. We closed at 180.11. And let me go look at a few of these to see whether we got volume in it. I'll take Barrick Gold first. Yeah, you get big volume. I love it. Okay, so Barrick is going into its swing point. Its swing point is 13 million as well as 21 million. And guess what? We did 22.4. So this is saying also, this is going to be intense. This run is on. Yeah, we just took out, so Barrick Gold just took out, this is pretty cool. Barrick Gold took out a consolidation that is back to April of 2018. That's saying Barrick's next move is going to 1552. You're at 1448. We put this on, I don't need a quarterly, I'll put it on a monthly. Yeah, I put this on a monthly and we're coming up there. So in Barrick's case, this is going to be pretty cool watching this tomorrow, folks, because on a monthly basis, right, if we take out 1454, which is only 6 pennies above where we are right now, and you have volume behind the move, it's like, hey, man, you know, you're going up to 2347. It's a monster move. It's a monster move. Let me just look at this. Yeah, it's a monster move. If we go take a look at Agnico Eagle, AEM, same setup. higher. This is an ABC structure up. These things aren't stopping. And an Eco Eagle's on its way up to 60. Right now you're at 48, 41. And let's go take a look at the two top ones. Those are the streamer stocks. That'd be Royal Gold. Oh, look at this. Yep. Royal Gold's going to be the first one to hit its all-time high. Check this out. Royal Gold, $98.06 today. The all-time high is $184. That's going to be a big number. The Royal Gold looks like it's going to blow this away tomorrow. And then Franco Nevada, FNV. If you haven't checked out the Gold Report, folks, great time to do it. Come over to our website at TFNN. Franco Nevada, same deal. Franco Nevada, a little lighter than, meaning away from its high, but Franco Nevada also wants to take out its high. 86.06 is the high in Franco Nevada. You're at 80.71 right now. And, oh, this is going to be cool. A weekly ABC up. 13 million, 6. It's going to be close whether they can do 13. Might not be able to do it. But Franco Nevada also wants its all-time high. So just getting a couple of the streamers to the all-time highs brings your probability much higher, folks, that the metal run is on, and that'll be saying that the dollar also is going to be pulling back. Dow up 38, NASDAQ up 33, S&P's up 5.5. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that we'll even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. So we had the Fed statement out, bottom line. That, of course, puts juice underneath the markets, particularly the bond market, the metals market. And then on top of that, folks, you had, it looks like Mnuchin's coming out saying that they're close to having the debt ceiling raised. And, of course, I suspect that's what actually put more juice under gold, because when you read this statement, it's pretty intense. It's like Trump administration officials and House and Senate leaders agreed they will raise the debt ceiling, but negotiations remain far apart on the issue of increasing spending cuts as they search for long-term budget deal. This is a White House suggested a one-year deal that would keep spending at current levels and also suspend the debt limit for a year, suspended, if a two-year agreement can't be reached. Mnuchin said taking automatic spending cuts known as sequesters off the table. Bottom line, it would be pretty intense, folks, if they just suspend the debt limit in general without adding another couple hundred billion or whatever they're going to add to it. Bottom line, what I expect you have there is that is putting more juice underneath this metals market. You get the ABC structure on the way up. We'll see what kind of action we get tomorrow inside the dollar. What I do expect we're going to see out here is that these markets, bottom line, look like they're going to go over the high. And yeah, it was that volume that came in yesterday, took out the B point, did it with volume, that's saying, hey, we're going to go over that high. Rates are going down. This is the first time that rates are going down in 10 years. Right now, if you look at the Fed Fund futures rate, they're at 100% rate cut on July 31st. For the second rate cut, you're at 66% for September 18th. So that is monster juice, one after another. That's saying that we get down to 1.75 to 2 by September 18th, which is right around the corner. That's the real bottom line. So we'll see where it shakes out. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night, and we look forward to speaking to you right back here tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock. Go get them, folks.